Right, good morning, folks. It's fourth morning of these extra sessions, and well, the main thing about this session will be yourself being introduced to a third rainbow shaman who you are very familiar with, as his life as Agastya. So Agastya's previous reincarnation as a rainbow shaman. And what I had in mind is that we will first do prep with Agastya. His Shakti is already in the air. And then we will dance with Agastya. And when we sit down, then we will take it from there with his previous rainbow shaman reincarnation. Just to repeat briefly the instructions for the dancing, Amrita Shakti dance. So you could chant the mantra aloud, in this case Agastya's mantra, Om Amrita Agastya Namaha, or you could just dance to Agastya, 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 give it a rhythm. But anyhow, I find it easiest that, you know, one is chanting the mantra, whether it's a guru mantra, whether it's a deity mantra you want to use, you're chanting it internally and you give it a rhythm, so it has a steady rhythm. When you have steady rhythm, then you are able to dance to it. Doesn't matter if the rhythm is slow or fast or changes between the two every few minutes perhaps. But when you have a steady rhythm, then you just dance to it without choreography. Of course, you can use, you know, if you know some dancing steps, of course you can use those. But what I mean by not having choreography is that we don't have a group choreography, which is actually a lovely idea to have like a, well, have some kind of simple choreography together, but so that you can practice it at home, you are free to dance in any way you like. Just to give you an idea, you know, it can be rhythmical dancing, just like when you would go to a dancing event or nightclub, and just feel free to dance in any way. But I also incorporate like a little bit of Vajrapodi, little bit of Amrita Asana. Like when I feel like doing a stretch, I stretch in any form I feel like doing it. When I feel like flexing my muscles for a moment, I do that. Yesterday I was, as we were doing this Amrita Shakti dance here, I was at one point on my back on the floor, moving to the rhythm, that to the mantra that was chanting internally. Then I was laying with my chest towards the floor and still dancing to it. I was on my fours at one point to give some movement for my spine. And then of course most of it I was standing, in standing position. So just to give you an idea that this is just movement we are creating to a musical rhythm. And this has the purpose of, you know, trauma creates an armor around the body, like a thick armor that makes the body stiff and hard, but also, what is that word? Makes our mind get stuck in different kinds of states of fear and anxiety and so on. So we purposefully dance and do it with a mantra, so that when we dance, our whole system is affected. Kind of the system takes in the charge, the Shakti of the mantra, to break that armor, to break it. And not in a, like, breaking it, but it just automatically crumbles away, sort of like a dry clay or dry mud. It just crumbles away. And maybe you felt it already, maybe you felt it before with dancing practice, but it is incredibly effective practice, as simple as it is. So let's do a few minutes prep of tuning in with Agastya, relaxing the body, and then we'll dance for maybe 20 minutes or so, and then we'll continue sitting with Agastya's previous reincarnation as Rainbow Shaman. Feel your whole body, feel your energy, feel your blood, feel your pulse. Feel the life in you and offer that life. Offering the life in your system at the feet of the Guru, at the feet of Agastya. And when I say that, also offer it to all sentient beings. This is not opposed to being at the feet of the Guru, because the nature of the Guru, the very nature of our own basic nature, pure nature, is the love and care of all beings. So when we offer ourselves at the feet of the Guru and then offer ourselves to the service of all beings, these two are not opposed. They are the same, exactly the same. But through linear thought, it cannot be understood. It needs to be understood through experience. Through experience, through recognition of our basic, pure, perfect nature and its qualities, its facets. So with love, with our whole being, prostrating at the feet of Agastya. Perhaps the most important Mahasiddha of all times. And with our prostration, inviting him to take us into his field. Take us into his energy. We are samsaric beings, and we should not forget that. And therefore, always when we approach our Guru, it should come from that place of acknowledging that we are samsaric beings, and because of that, on a standing on an unstable ground. And therefore we are turning to Guru Agastyaji with sincerity, humbly, with devotion, with love, with dedication. And if we want, if we feel like it, if we are ready, then also with commitment, with dedication. Okay, Master, I'm here, I know the trouble I'm in, and I want to commit to you. I want to dedicate my life to this relationship and what it cultivates, what it reveals. Whoever asks for the blessings of the Guru, attention from the Guru, sincerely, if it comes from a sincere place, the blessing comes instantly, without an exception. But if that sincerity is compromised, if there is something, some other motivations, then very difficult to. This blocks us, creates a block in us. And if there's a block, the Guru sees it immediately. So attitude is very, very important. Feeling Agastya's lovely, isn't it lovely, his presence, very sweet, loaded with this very rich and in that sense intense, loving, peaceful bliss. Let's chant Agastya's mantra, Om Amrita Agastya Namaha, a minute or two. Om Amrita Agastya Namaha, 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 Om Amrita Agastya Namaha. All right, very good. You can take space for yourself and start dancing with Agastya. All right, let's continue. It was a good dancing session. And then about 10 minutes relaxing. Thanks from our hearts with our vital energy, with our blood, with our emotional energy, thanking Agastya. We are always practicing to reveal our potential, our most basic, pure and perfect nature of mind and of body, and to attain the so-called immortality or rainbow body, light body. We have that potential already. And because our basic nature, you know, we are connected. Nature, life is connected. It's why this is not a self-centered or selfish or self-concerned endeavor. It's really a revealing of life itself in this body, in this mind. And even though the realization, the revelation happens in this body, it belongs to all life. It is about all life. And because of that, others, all life around us belongs to it, belongs to the process. So may all beings get the benefits from our practice, whether whatever the practice is, wisdom side, trauma healing side, which we are doing now. May all beings benefit. May all beings in all realms benefit and return to original ease, original bliss. Original state of body and mind. So with love, with our whole being, thanks to Agastya, and with that same love and with sincerity, inviting his blessings from his former reincarnation, from the early days of Shaiva. You could perhaps say from the days of Shaiva shamanism, when there was no clear distinction between Tantra and shamanism. So inviting the blessings of a rainbow shaman, a medicine man, a yogi, a master called Amarji. Amarji. A-M-A-R-J-I. Amarji. Amarji, Amarji, Amarji. Namo Amarji. Namo Amarji. Namo Amarji. Om Amrita Amarji Namaha. Let's sing. Om Amrita Marji Namaha. 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 Amritamarji Namaha. Om Amritamarji Namaha. Om Amritamarji Namaha. Om Amritamarji Namaha. Amritamarji Namaha. Om 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 Amrita Marji Namaha. Om Amrita Marji Namaha. Om Amrita Marji Namaha. Om Amrita Marji Namaha. Namaha. Om Amrita Marji ॐ अमृतामर्जी नमः ॐ अमृतामर्जी नमः Very good. Lie down. Express a gratitude to Amarji. With our whole being, with our whole body. Thank you so much. May each one of us get healed. May each one of us return to our basic enlightened state. And may all beings benefit from what we do. May all beings benefit. Internally taking bodhisattva vows. I'm vowing to liberate all sentient beings. Vowing to put an end to confusion, delusion, trauma. Vowing to practice the Dharma that liberates. And vowing to attain great perfection. Vowing to reveal our potential in full. Taking refuge in the five jewels. You can think of a guru or several gurus. In Amrita Mandala we have a small group of heart gurus from the side of Buddhist Tantra, Hindu Tantra, and after these 5 days of training also from, should I say, rainbow shamanism, enlightened shamanism. We have very close masters from Taoist immortals too. So taking refuge in a guru or this group of gurus, masters, taking refuge in the pure land of Guru or pure lands, the abodes of these masters. Taking refuge in the pure enlightened nature in us, everywhere, in all things. Taking refuge in the teachings, practices, instructions, transmissions, including our own effort. Taking refuge in effort. Taking refuge in diligence. Taking refuge in not giving up. Never giving up until our internal work is finished. taking refuge in the community of bodhisattvas, practitioners taking refuge in the Sangha, our community, our group, taking refuge in Mahasangha of all beings, taking refuge in the Satsangha, in the company of enlightened masters. With every cell of our bodies, with every bit of our subtle bodies, may all beings be free. May all beings be free of suffering, self-delusion, existential confusion. May all beings be free of not knowing who they are or where they are, what their purpose is. May all beings be free of that. May all beings be free of psychic injuries, psychic damage through their own actions, through the harm that has been done to them, to us. May all beings be free of that. And may all beings get the benefits directly. May all beings get the benefits of our practice. May all beings get the merit of our practice to help them with readiness instead of being stuck in the rut of samsara, of confusion, pain, delusion. May the merit pass to them. Help them to realize that there is pure being inside them, never apart from them, never away, and that there is light of Dharma that leads to that light, leads to revealing the original body and mind. Mm-hmm.